All right, so we'll go ahead and get started. I think it's about 1 o'clock right now. I know people are kind of going to trickle in from lunchtime. But I'll just go ahead and get this thing kicked off. Thank you guys for coming out to this session. I'm very excited to talk about. It's called The Rise of API-First Applications. As a quick introduction, my name is Travis Tidwell. I'm the CTO and co-founder of Form.io. We're one of the sponsors here, so some of you guys have come by and said hello. And very excited to offer that solution to developers. I'll talk a little bit about it at the very beginning of this session. You can find me on Twitter. I'm Software Gnome. Don't expect much from me. I don't tweet that much, but it'd be great if you came and followed me. I like to keep up to tune with what's going on the web, and that's one way I do it. Where you'll really see me on is github.com. I'm Travis T on GitHub, so I've got a number of open source libraries. Primarily JavaScript, a lot of Node.js, but really everything I do in the marketplace, I put on GitHub, including this presentation, including all source code. So you guys can get on there and find this presentation. If you guys want to fork it and modify it and use it on your own presentations, feel free. Before we do get started, I would like to just talk very quickly about Form.io. So we are a combined form and API platform for developers. So the idea is we're offering a very easy to use drag and drop form builder interface that allows you to build a form using tools that you're very familiar with. Each of the fields that you drag on there, you can create custom validations using JavaScript, and all of the validations execute on both the front and the back end at the same time. But in the process of building a form, we're essentially saying that you've defined an API schema. So over on the left-hand side, you have a form. On the right-hand side, you have an API. Where the rubber really meets the road is whenever you want to embed those forms into your custom application, which you can do using a very simple AngularJS directive. And that makes the form come alive in your single-page application. And it's a REST-driven API platform, very easy to use. We have a free offering, so if you want to come just try it out, just create an account, and we'd be happy to have you. So with that said, I'd like to move on. Another thing that I like to do is offer presentation materials. Sometimes this board can be really hard to read, so you can actually go online and view this on your own computer if you just want to have it right there in front of you. There are some movies in this video, in this presentation, so I think if we all did that, it'd probably take the network down, which I don't think there's any surprise there. So maybe later tonight, if you want to revisit this presentation, feel free. The URL's right there. Also, you can find me on GitHub, Travis T. I have a repo called Presentations that I have, and this repo is up there as well. And I do a lot of YouTube videos, and in fact, this presentation I'll be posting on my own YouTube channel, as well as I have a lot of other tutorials on MeanStack. I'm very into Node.js, server-side JavaScript, as well as front-end JavaScript. And then, of course, I have a website, travistudwell.com. So I think what I'd like to talk about in this presentation is that something is happening in the web. And I think all of you know this. I don't think that really comes as a surprise. But there's a lot of interesting paradigm shifts that have been happening recently within the web. And if you really want to dive deep into understanding what these paradigm shifts and what these trends are, it's almost enlightening to start off by going to trends.google.com, and you'll see a number of things that are occurring. On the very top, I know it's hard to read, so on the very top left graph, you have Internet of Things diagram, which is people doing searches for Internet of Things. The top right is a AngularJS, which all of you know what AngularJS is. In my opinion, AngularJS is an enabling technology that allows you to build apps differently that allows you to interface with Internet of Thing type of architectures. The bottom left is MeanStack. The MeanStack is a Node.js based stack application, which is skyrocketing as well. And then on the bottom right, you have REST APIs. One thing that I find very interesting about these diagrams